inside the forest is much warmer than at our dacha. Here is no wind and it feels like about -1, -2. And at our dacha with a strong wind, it is like -15. We have such cold temperature for a few days. At the end of the week, they promise +2, +1. So it will be warm again, comparatively warm for this time of the year. I would like to show you guys the Russian place of attraction. It is called Tarzanka. Very popular with kids and teenagers. That is a very, very long rope with a small stick. So, Alex, show how it works. Положи поводок. So guys, it is called Tarzanka, a very popular, I don't know, attraction with kids and teenagers. It is a very long rope with a small stick attached to the rope, and here is the ladder. So during summer, if you do not think, during summer this place is crowded with kids from our dacha community. So, I will show you how it works, but I am afraid because I may fall. So, just a little bit. Oh, I'm very old for this, guys. But Shefi liked it. Yeah, Shefi? Shefi. So guys, we have returned back to this point where we started. So we went with Alex in that direction. So over there was our Tarzanka attraction, and now we shall go here to the pond. Here we have a beautiful pond. Today is the middle of November, the 13th of November, Tuesday, вторник, 13 ноября. Expensive dacha, guys, very beautiful, with such metal entrance. As you may see, they do not grow anything here, just come to spend weekends to relax here. They have winter water, that is what we have on our small territory, on our dacha. Here, guys, as you may see, also people do not grow anything, just a place to spend time with the family. You may see the dachas that are very close to the forest have metal shutters on the windows. That is for protection of the property. In the middle of the dacha community, usually people do not put metal shutters on windows, but here on the border with the forest, people are afraid that some robbers, thieves may come and steal something from the house. Sometimes it happens. It was especially popular in the times of perestroika. A lot of thieves went around Dutch communities and tried to steal everything. It doesn't matter, old, new things, everything. Oh. Every year in spring we came to our dacha and repaired the door. We had nothing inside the house, but they did not know this, and the thieves broke the door, broke windows, and finally they left without touching anything because no valuable things were inside the house. But we had to repair every year the door and the windows. Once I told my granny, let's leave the door open. In this case, we do not need to repair it in spring. So it was a joke, but well, there is some truth in any joke, as you know. So now we are near the pond where Shafi loved to swim during summer. Шефи, нельзя, там лед. Now the pond is covered with ice, as you may see. Over there is some big storage or maybe factory. That is why a lot of noise here. We do not hear it at our dacha, but the nearest dachas. Шефи, нельзя, пойдем. Нельзя. Шефи wants to go into the water. So guys, let's go to the exit from the forest and we shall show you a very modern way to open the forest gate, the forest door. Here it is called Lesnaya Kalitka или Калитка в лес. So that is the modern lock. Alex was surprised that it works from the first time. Usually it takes 2-3 times to open because the key does not work correctly every time. So a very modern system in a very old Dutch community. So guys, while we are here, let's go. I will show you that not only some ugly wooden rustic houses we have, but also very expensive ones, many storied brick buildings you may find here. So you may see the brick building here. I can't say that I like it, but it is a very expensive construction. The high fence they have. Шеф, пойдем. Там может быть собака. Пошли. Honestly speaking, guys, I do not like such big stone houses, because it is difficult to heat them during winter period, and during summer it is not very cozy inside. They are also very cold. So not practical for our climate. Wooden houses, small wooden houses are much better. So it is comfortable inside during summer, and during winter period it doesn't take much wood to heat the house. Usually people put here electric heaters. That is the cheapest way, because usually people come here just for a few hours. We also brought an electric heater here, but some people have stoves, wood stoves. So the stoves that are heated with wood. Usually people heat with wood because we have a lot of wood in the nearest forest, so no coal. In the south, many years ago, my grandmother lived in the south of Russia, and there she heated her private house with coal. Углем топили. I don't know why, maybe it was cheaper that way. So, but here no one heats with coal, only with gas, if you have gas, or with electricity. So that is our pond. And we went over there. There is another pond. I return to close the lock here. That is from rain. So guys, thank you for watching this episode. Thank you for your support. Thank you for watching video on my small different stuff channel. Thank you for everything. Goodbye. See you soon. Пока.